This is Sheikh Dawood Parveen, Assistant Professor in Chevrolet Engineering College. Today our topic is demand forecasting. What is the meaning and definition of demand forecasting? In demand forecasting, first of all, what is the today our topic is demand forecasting. In demand forecasting, first of all, what is the meaning and definition of a demand forecasting? Demand forecasting is a systematic process that involves anticipating the demand for the product and services of an organization in future under a set of uncontrollable and competitive forces. Accurate demand forecasting is essential for a firm to enable it to produce the required quantities at the right time and arrange well in advance for various imports. That is the importance or essential for a demand forecasting to a firm. In the words of Cundiff and Still, the demand forecasting is an estimate of sales during a specific future period based on proposed marketing plan and a set of particular uncontrollable and competitive forces. So that is the definition of a Cundiff and Still is demand forecasting is an estimate of sales during a specific future period based on proposed marketing plan and a set of particular uncontrollable and competitive forces. Demand forecasting enables an organization to take various business decisions such as planning the production, process of production, purchasing of raw material from suppliers, managing the funds from the financial institutions, borrowing the amount from the financial institutions by the help of loans, and deciding the price of the product after production is completed. That is to fix the price for a particular product. The price fixation is like that which does not give loss to the company and at the same time which increase the sales of a product. An organization can forecast demand by making own estimates called guess estimate or taking the help of specialization consultants or market research agencies. Sometimes that is if the companies, that is the investment of the company or turnover of the company is very less, or low turnover companies are depending upon the demand estimation, depending upon the guessing of demand. And but the larger companies are the companies which turnover is very huge, so they depends upon the marketing research agencies. Before going to discuss about the methods of forecasting, first of all, that is we discuss about what is the use or what are the benefits of forecasting. So these are all called as a decisions that need forecast. Which market to pursue, what products to produce, how many people to hire, how many units to purchase, how many units to produce, and so on. These are the decision areas of a demand forecasting. That means the which market, that is for estimating the future demand, which market gives the correct information about the demand estimation. That is which market gives accurate information. And next of all, that is the what products to produce, what type of the products to produce for purchasing in the market, and how many people to hire, how many units to purchase means that is a raw material quantity, how many units to produce, that means output quantity, and so on. So these are the decisions that need forecast. And next of all, that is what are the common characteristics of forecastings. Forecastings are rarely perfect. Forecasts are more accurate for aggregate data than for individual items. That means estimating the future demand, it gives a accurate data for to overall industry when comparing to a single firm. That means that information or the data which is collected by the help of a demand forecasting, which it is suitable for overall industry. Next, forecasts are more accurate for shorter than longer time periods. Demand forecast is forecasting information gives a accurate data for short run. Short run means that is a below 1 year period. That is the data which gives in a demand forecasting, which it is suitable for below 1 year demand estimation when comparing to longer time period. Longer time period means from 2 to 10 years. Next, what are the forecasting steps? What are the forecasting steps? The steps of forecasting means that is for estimating the future demand. What type of steps? That is, what are the steps helpful for estimating the future demand? So the first step is that what needs to be forecast, level of details, unit of analysis, and time horizon required. What data is available to evaluate? What data is available to evaluate means that is some company containing the past data. Past data means that is the last 1 year data, 2 years data. So this data is helpful for estimating the future demand. Next, select and test the forecasting model. Cost, ease of use, and accuracy. The testing and selecting and testing the forecasting model. Generate the forecast. From this all, that is to generate the forecast and monitor the forecasting accuracy over time. So these are the steps for estimating the future demand. Next, types of forecast model. Forecast models are divided into two types, qualitative methods and quantitative methods. Qualitative methods are technological methods. Technological methods such as the general method, the survey methods and expert opinion, time series analysis, test marketing. So these are all called as a qualitative methods. And quantitative methods are the statistical and mathematical methods are called as a quantitative methods. Now we discuss about what are the models or what are the methods of a demand forecasting. Models are methods of a demand forecasting with the help of a flow chart. Today our topic is demand forecasting. What are the methods of demand forecasting? Today our topic is what are the methods of demand forecasting. So first of all, what is demand? Demand means that is the every want. Demand means that is every want supported by the willingness and ability to buy a particular product is called as a demand for the product. Forecasting. So forecasting means that is the estimation about the future. That is to forecasting means that is to estimate about future. So demand forecasting means that is to estimate about the future demand for a particular product is a demand forecasting. This demand forecasting is very difficult exercise. There are various methods of demand forecasting differing in terms of their accuracy and sophistication. The method of demand forecasting may be broadly divided into two categories. That is, they are broadly divided into two categories. There are survey method and statistical method. Survey method and statistical. Now we come to the topic, methods of demand forecasting. Methods of demand forecasting. The methods of demand forecasting. The demand forecasting methods are divided into two types. That is the opinion polling method and the statistical method. That is the demand forecasting methods. The first one is opinion polling method and the second one is statistical method. So first of all, that is opinion polling method. Opinion polling method means that is that to take the opinion of the customer or a sales force, that is called as a opinion polling method. Second one, that is a statistical method. Statistical method means that is to take the with the help of statistical or mathematical expressions to estimate the demand for the product is called as a statistical method. In opinion polling method, there are three different types of methods in a opinion polling method. That is the first one, consumer survey method, sales force opinion method, expert opinion method. Sales force opinion method and expert opinion method. This says consumer survey method is another divided into three types. This consumer survey method is another divided into three types. First one is a complete enumeration survey, sample survey, and test marketing, and last one end use. But in statistical methods, the statistical methods are another divided into four types. There are the trend projection method, barometric techniques method, regression method, simulation equation method. There are in statistical method, trend projection method, barometric technique method, regression method, and simulation equation method. This trend projection method is another divided into different types. There are the first one, fitting trend line by observation method, least square method, time series analysis, moving averages method, and exponential smoothing method, So these are the different methods of a demand forecasting. The demand forecasting methods, if you observe the flow chart of a methods of demand forecasting, there are two methods, opinion polling and statistical method. The opinion polling method is another divided into three types: complete enumeration and survey method, sample survey, tests and test marketing, end use. The statistical methods are divided into four types: trend projection, barometric method, regression method, simulation, equation method. This trend projection method is another divided into five types: fitting trend line by observation, least square linear regression, time series analysis, moving averages, and exponential smoothing.